the most important plant. It captures the moisture. Along the clouds of moisture going down, well, I say clouds pass, 85% of all tropical trees get their starts in areas like this, where a great big tree in the background there broke off, snapped down, broke branches down and cleared other small trees, and generally wiped out the shrubs and herbs that were there, allowing the light to hit the forest floor. When invasive trees can be 2 inches in diameter and be 50 years old, waiting for this light so that they can break up through the herbs and shrubs and go on towards their destiny. The trees come down with all these different types of little vines coming together. You think of roots in the soil, and you think you hear sometimes of some plants producing roots that go up into the bromeliads, but a lot of 15 different families of trees in the tropical cloud forest produce roots like this, something like this, from the branches, like figs, but instead of coming down to the soil like this particular fig is doing, they go up into the humus along the tree where the dead and decaying around that area there. That may see like that one over there. There's a few trying to struggle over it.
Trigona stinging. Huh?
Those are small, tiny stingless bees called the Trigona stingless bees. And it would be one of the things that I'd be looking for if I was lost in the forest. Years old and had no investigate bird. Sitting right there, just about scared it off. I don't want to do that. Anybody see it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A rusty gate bird or the violin. It sounds like somebody tuning up a violin.
Oh, I heard you.
It's like, the time has come. There, it's a bluish back and gray belly. It's a beautiful bird. Eric flew over.
Yeah, it's still there.
Just, yeah, but it hopped over one step for people who want to look at it.
Yeah, it's showing us its back
right now.
Otherwise,
it's pretty dull bird. It blends in nice to it in the environment. And if I hadn't been blabbing so much, I never would have seen it. It's sitting there now, very calm, cool and collected, and giving a good look. And chemicals used for chemotherapy and cancer. It's one of the top six, like the Witheringia, the tomato. This is one of the, out of 106 samples of this plant, 93 of those samples had these chemicals in them. If you want to read about those types of things, you can write to the Missouri Botanical Gardens. They're doing a lot of studies in conjunction with the Smithsonian Institute, who have done a lot of collecting in a book that I have from 1981. Shows that 10% of all tropical plants, and those are the easier ones, in other words, you have 30,000, 3,000 of them have medicinal properties. And out of the 360 different genera collected, 240 of them, from a scale of 1 to 10, had, that's me counting them, one for one, 240 of them had one of the, probably a wasp larvae, it, kind of like a sore on the plant. My father, he fanned out the rarest bushes that would catch in my grandmother's stocking. I love my grandparents a lot. They were a great influence in my life. And this, will eventually sometimes weight the branch down and cause the branch to break. But it's a giant straw. It comes down into the ground and like at the end of my arm. Oh, there's a lizard. Small lizard in there. I'll leave him alone again. Coming down from the canopy, it's a tree that takes 75 to 150 years to start at the top and come down over its host too. It covers up the light of the host tree. It competes for nutrients around the base. And then it anatomizes around the trunk, eventually causing the demise. Eight trees for the diameter. The sapotillo, it has a Monstera tenuis plant growing on it, a winged philodendron, and bromeliads, and moss. And I've even seen a long time ago, I saw a two-charred sloppy. The justice plant, the Acanthus. Brassacea bloom over a long period of time. Here's a beautiful one for a close-up camera shot. Water dripping off of the color and the here with the bare branches, but if you look under it, you see wrap on her. It's fantastic. Aren't you just guys enthralled by
yes.
it?
Yes.
This goes to show the colors.
Yes, you do.
Big shake.
Energy.
Tree.
So they abort between 20 and 80% of their crop.
It's a phylum right there.
They have a
mellow stone.
Way to the tip, secondary veins that run all the way to the tip also, and then joined more or less by horizontal lines. A little bit different than Pilea. And this family, about 90-95% of the family, all of them, whether they be shrubs or herbs or as a similar venation, but the leaves, secondary veins, kind of fade out of the picture, I call peter out at the edges.
Mm-hmm.
But they look somewhat similar.
Mm-hmm.
But this tree, and you see a bunch of, you can step, anybody can walk down here and
green
take a look.
Green-colored orchids on the top.
People can see the orchids. Now, if we were to take a knife and cut into tropical forests at 5,000 feet in Costa Rica, even in the Talamancas or up on Poas, this is the type of vegetation that you would see. You'd find our cecropia trees that have the symbiotic relationships with any poppies and the tomatoes family. And some of them are in the cotton family. Cotton families in Costa Rica, the Malvas, this plant right here that can diarrhea in children with flowers and made into a tea.
And used for diarrhea.
Those are coffees. Yeah, coffee.
And then there's an autograph plant over the orchids grow on the way on the top.
You see those fruits over there too, those kind of brown things.
Yeah.
Then we have our sapote tree, that's one of the biggest trees, around 30 meters. We have the flat canopy tree with the orchids on top, that's Longiocarpus. That's a legume, a nitrogen picture. And then over there with the wind, then over here to the far right and in the back is a ginseng tree that's growing in a tree. It's another tree that sends down a huge, enormous aerial root to the soil and establishes itself in the canopy. Why do so many plants grow up there? Well, like I said before, they don't have to compete with the light here on the forest floor. But another thing is that their fruits are so sweet that birds and animals are attracted to them. In this forest, they grow the relative store fruits. Also, we have animals that come down to the ground to pick up fruits, basement shrubs, where they'll be off the ground so that the land rodents that abound in this forest, the night feeders, a month of renting those facilities. But you can't see it how high it is. It's about 1,842 meters. That's a lot of here we hear a very rare bird, it's just one call, you heard monotone, the Zeladonia coronata, better known as the wren thrush. Let's see the calls again. You can also hear the slaty-back nightingale thrush singing. That really high-pitched. Now you can see the sapote fruits out there in the opening, beyond the big branch. The big branch also has sapote in it. And we're now at the moss-fed cascade.
Boy, it's missing.
Pink flower, an orchid up there. Is that an orchid up there, that pink flower? It's called Cavendishia complexus. It has a prefoliate leaf, and the flowers come out of the leaf. And right out of the stem. It's a beautiful plant, related to the rhododendron. One of the major adults in 1971, first came into the forest and first came out. Amiflora, that is another rhododendron relative. We call it the lipstick bush. It looks like a little tiny lipstick. Yeah, that's it's called a metal mark. Metal mark. There he is, I got him. Boy, Dylan.
Oh, I can see him.
Yeah. It's not the one I thought it at all. It's not the one that I was metal mark.
Ooh, more from 3.5 inches in diameter.
Be careful, Franklin. The birds were complaining. Emerald toucanettes. Small toucan. Well, he eats big birds. In between the two trees, the cecropia tree where the emerald toucanettes are, and the big tree to the right, there's some birds back there. They are. See them back over there? Flying around? Those are the ones that are going on. It'd be like having a 4.5 foot or 5 foot of the boll weevil. The boll weevil's long dead and gone, has been for a couple of months now. But as this fungus develops off the body fluids, it'll eventually explode, and the spores probably can be carried further away as these insects die on the upper basement of the forest floor. They'll crawl up there, be disoriented, and die. While this aromatic odor to them related to the pipers, they tie them to a long stick and put them in pools and freshwater streams. They break this material up tied to a stick and move, notice the action, move the water with it, and the animals come over and have plants and they're getting close to the beds. They are trying to find them. These fiddleheads can sometimes, they say they're a delicacy, but so are pufferfish, and there are cases where people have eaten them. They can be pretty tough on the system. Cows that eat the bracken.
Crystal plant, the rose. I mean, hey, yeah.
I think that's going to look prettier. It looks prettier in the picture. It's so far away, it's like dots. But, oh well.
Charges an incredibly high price for it. around it because it's got enough height. That's okay. It looks
blue, dark, royal blue. Another one was same kind of color, yellow and blue, but on a long fish.
enough to get it.
Look, get that toy. Get that toy. Good girl. Good girl, Chris. Get that toy.
Get the toy.
Get the toy. Come on, just jump in there. Get the toy. Gina, get the toy. Chris, get the toy.
I don't think it'll come off though. Aww. Wedged in there.
Well, how are you doing?
Hey.
Right.
Can you read a Julie?
Please do a wedding video. It was very nice. And then we put on our wedding video. So now we're gonna go to a real wedding. So that'll be boring.
Have you ever looked at the pictures? Do the scrapbook
of our wedding? We didn't. Not today.
No, theirs.
Oh, theirs. Yes.
No, he took all the pictures.
Well,
now that you have those dogs, you won't have to go to Saudi Arabia.
Does it mean they were the best?
Really?
Yeah, I didn't get him. Thank you.
Arenal volcano. It's as much as we're going to see of it, covered in clouds.
Del pueblo, bueno. Del pueblo, sí.
Creo que parece, sí. Es que me parece que he visto el rótulo.
Sí.
Yendo para Tilarán, eso.
Sí,
Okay, here we are at Arenal Lodge and...
having a beer.
Having a beer. And the volcano just erupted, the Arenal volcano. And there's the plume of smoke.
Oh, I'm going to get my big camera.
Coming up. Just look at that. It was a big, deep rumble. And wow. Today we drove 2 hours out of the way. Went right by this place. Drove another 2 tough hours on dirt roads. Finally we got into the place because it was locked up when we came by first. So you see the smoke is that was belched out over the volcanoes drifting to the west from the volcano. And there is Lake Arenal way over there. It's just the very eastern tip of it. It goes from east to west, probably 50 or 60 kilometers.
And we know it backwards and forwards. Fun to go on that tour tonight.
Y te dicen, como es la niebla no se mira, te dicen.
There's the yellow one on the very next fence post back, but you probably can't see him. Or something. They just dove down. Now look at this one right here. It's fake.
kidding.
He eats tuna sandwich.
Ah.
Likes that, huh?
There it is.
View of our villa, Mariposa Inn, Capos, Costa Rica. Sunrise over Capos, Costa Rica.
Cruisers, no, that's what those are, and he said they always come blocks.
Yeah.
The picture there. It's real pretty. Checking out everything.
He's sticking his head up above there.
Mm-hmm. It's real, real pretty blue. His missus came in down below.
Manuel Antonio Park. This is it. Okay, we have record. Do you guys want to turn around and show us your faces?
Oh, happy day.
Oh, you have, okay.
Beach number 3, Manuel Antonio.
Beautiful. There's monkeys in these trees.
Okay. I saw one this morning.
No, I don't see him.
There he is.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's different from the one we saw this morning. I always thought this morning was the biggest one. That's the trouble. Whenever you get in this park, that's why I go back to our cabin. You run out of film. Yeah, that'd be neat to know.
So that's a poisonous one, huh?
Well, not so good. Is that the same kind?
Yeah.
Ooh, look at the eyes. Oh, my God. Somebody said they saw one yesterday, and it had a toad in it.
Oh my! Really?
Yeah. I thought maybe monkeys.
I was taking a picture of a vine.
I don't know. Oh, there it is. I can't, it's hard to find his head.
He's going after that brain. Oh, wow. What if I need a zoom for that, but that's too far away. That's right. That's enough. Big picture of the screen.
Look at his eyes.
Oh, yeah.
They really do slither.
It's out of all the trees, huh?
This is rounder and bigger. I think it might have been the same kind.
Different diameter or actually longer?
Both.
Oh.
Oh, and we're right in that hole and he grabbed something. He's got something. Look at him.
Oh, I've lost him now.
It's right in the fork of the tree there.
You know what? Let me get the binoculars back.
I know. That's what I'm trying to do. It's so hard to...
It's right up here.
Okay.
This tree
in
right
the, in the fork there?
Yeah.
Maybe it's just as good.
He does. He's striped just like that.
Rainy day in Cape.